As you can see on your screens, it is a touch of color. Unaona yellow pale, red pale. And of course, that's a sign that you are right in the kitchen right here on Daybreak. We really appreciate your time and company each and every Thursday. You join us and we get to have an exciting time just cooking and getting to learn about the different chefs who come to grace our show. And we appreciate you. Wewe ambaye umekuwa very committed, umekuwa ukichukua notes, umekuwa ukijaribu. We'd like to hear your feedback. What has been happening? Have you improved in your cooking skills? Show us pictures of what you've tried in the last few weeks and we'll be able to just, you know, appreciate that with you. Today we want to make another, you know, amazing delicacy right here in studio. And of course, I'm having a panel of two gentlemen, my chefs, wale experts. Last week, tulikuwa na Chef Onesmus. Leo ameamua, wacha aende alete mwalimu wake. The person that he said amemuinspire, amemshika mkono kwa industry, and they are here just to help us, you know, cook something very interesting, and I'd just like them to say something, you know. Karibuni sana.
Asante sana.
All the way from Naivasha. Habari ya Naivasha?
Nzuri sana. Yes, yes.
Mbona mnakaa baridi baridi?
Wena si mzuri.
Kama tuwashe gas kidogo.
Tabidi tutaota gas kiasi.
Tuchemshe mama hapa jikoni.
Tuwamuom.
Sindio? Mko sawa?
Kabisa.
Ulikuwa umepotea wapi?
Ah, international classes kidogo hapa na pale. Angalia tu hapo. Yeah. Hapa tu na pale. Now I'm back. Uh-huh. And I'm officially really coming back to introduce Chef Onesmus to the industry. Uh-huh. And it's another chef I'm introducing very soon. I want to grow the industry. Uh-huh. Asante ni sana.
All right. Onesmus, karibu
yes.
sana.
Asante, asante. Uh-huh. Kama venye chef wangu amemwambia, huyu ndio my teacher. Nafuata steps. Uh-huh. Pole pole tu. Leo tumekuja, tuko timu kubwa. So, chukua kalamu na karatasi, andika, mambo yako utafanya baadaye. Sisi yetu tunafanya sahi. Yes.
Live. Yeah. Sasa hapa, mambo inakuanga simple, but ukiona young by the way, you just expect some surprise somewhere. Mambo kwa simple, but ukiona young kwa round, hatujui nini leo itafanyika. So, mi nakuona tu mapema mapema, but what we're gonna be making is very simple, and I'd just like Chef Young, yeah? Tell us what are we making this morning, and run us through the ingredients. Kuna watu wako na hizi vitu, so wanataka wapike asubuhi. Saisi, tukipika, wanapika.
Aya, today we are making lioness potatoes and we're gonna have stir-fried chicken breasts and some sausages. Mm-hmm. Kitu simple. Yes. Leo sina buembe mingi. Leo sina buembe.
Tutaona, si tuko hapa.
Onesmus, tutacheza na moto.
All right.
Yes.
So leo kuna msaidizi. Wacha nikuje inside.
Yes, sasa nataka acheze kama yeye.
All right.
Perfect.
So chicken stir fry, lioness potatoes,
yes.
na sausages hapo.
Yes, yes.
Hii chakula ni ya supper, ni ya breakfast ama ni ya lunch?
Hii ni simple breakfast. Okay. Ambayo unado enjoy kama wewe. Hapa tuko na potato chips. Uh-huh. Normal potato chips. Uh-huh. We have all-purpose flour. We have two eggs. We have here onions, coriander stems and garlic. We have our own chopped onions, we have ketchup, we have honey. Sasa ni masaa kudonjo. Hapa tuko na cornstarch, hapa tupo na salt. Mm-hmm. Yeah, just now. Start seasoning our flour. Mm-hmm. Put this in that hot oil. Then we're gonna be starting with the sausages first, then we change our gloves.
All right.
So this is beef. This is chicken.
All right. Ah, we'll see mix.
Yes. Yeah. We change our gloves after that.
All right.
Now we start here.
So we go in with the sausages.
Yes, yes.
Amesema, this is simple breakfast.
Simple.
So we are right on time. Sai ni sambili na 17 hapo, eh?
Yes.
I'm sure I'll see wengi washakunywa chai. So kama haukuwa na plan, now you do. Yeah.
Unapata content hapa sasa ya breakfast.
Yeah, you at least you can try.
Pole pole tu.
All right. So kwa nini kwa hizo potatoes, did you like boil them? Did you like pre-prep them? Ama ziko hivyo?
Ziko.
It's always good to know.
Yeah, ipo hivyo. I've not prepped them.
Uh-huh.
I've just peeled them, washed them. Then I've used my potato cutter.
Mm-hmm.
Just to have that perfect shape.
Yeah, ipate shape. Ya, kwa wale mekua mkiuliza, ni aje zinakaa hivyo, ndo hii silaha, ndo hii tool yenye metumika. Ndio uweze kupata hiyo.
Hiyo shape ambayo tunataka.
Nice shape, eh? Ni kama tu, ni kama bajia, lakini sasa with a, with a different touch, eh?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
As that goes on, I start to make, doing my mixing mm-hmm. on the other side. I have to change that glove to another one.
Mm-hmm.
After this, you change your gloves.
Okay. After I prepare this.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Najua ni mwalimu sasa.
Ujue sasa leo ukifanya mambo yako kwisha wewe.
Siwezi choma. Siwezi choma.
Anataka kuona kama kenye una amekuwa akikufunza you know. Mlipatana wapi na Onesmus and what did you see in him that
actually
inspired?
I usually teach in different colleges
mm-hmm.
when I was there in their college. I noticed how he was asking me a lot of questions and how he was interested.
Mm-hmm.
Then I saw, he has potentials.
Mm-hmm.
The way he's asking me our questions, I saw, okay. Nimse anona mbali, tena nimse nezam train.
Mm-hmm.
Then I took him in my camp. I told him, kuja tujaribu.
Mm-hmm.
Then nikampatia probation kidogo. I observed him when I'm doing my international cookings.
Mm-hmm.
After seeing what he can do, sabu, this guy you are seeing here amepikia bahati.
Mm-hmm.
The guy you are seeing here.
Ah, okay.
Yes.
Amepata bahati ya kupikia bahati, eh?
Yes.
Na nikapata bahati ya kupikia yang pia. Yoyu hapa.
Yeah, yeah. So, I'm introducing him to my other team.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, first, amepatana na my first team. There's another team sasa.
Mm.
I want him to meet. When he's ready to meet the team, hapo sasa atakuwa amefika ile place nataka.
Atakuwa kidogo ya, naenda vizuri.
Yeah.
So tumefika, tuambie kidogo kuhusu vile umeandaa hii.
Oh, this chicken was marinated for the past 24 hours, then stored in the fridge. I just used cooking oil, salt, dry and wet fresh spice, coriander, black pepper.
Mm-hmm.
Hivo tu
mm-hmm.
na mafuta.
24 hours
in the fridge.
So now unaweka kwa?
Kwa unga. Ambayo hii unga bado jiko na cornstarch kiasi.
Mm-hmm.
Then we move it here to our egg dip.
Mm. Na kuna salt pia kiasi ilikuwa imewekwa hapo.
Yes, yes. Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Then ina move to the potato chips
mm-hmm.
to coat. To coat in our potato chips.
Mm-hmm. Wow, who knew that you could actually be that creative with the stuff you have in the kitchen. You just sort of like crush them.
Yeah, put them together.
Mm-hmm.
Now this one, get out of this.
All right.
Place them here.
Mm.
Place them here.
All right, so our sausages are ready.
Yes, sausages are ready.
Mwona pale vile anajaribu kukontroli hiyo moto, eh? Ikiwa juu sana, they could actually burn.
Yes, yes. Mika hapo.
There you go. Amazing.
Aya, now this part, kwanza, zima hii kwanza, tuma, na kwa jomalizi hapo.
Mm-hmm. Potato karibu zina hivyo.
Okay.
Alright, so kitchen imeanza kuchangamuka sasa, ya?
Yes,
kuna joto kiasi na pia.
Akiendelea hapo. Remember, I've changed my gloves habu nimeguza kuku.
Yeah.
Now, we get to this one. Remember, when cooking, don't use iron. Mm-hmm. Iron oxidizes kwa chakula.
Ah, okay. The yes, spoons zile zimetengenezwa na chuma. So plastic, yeah?
Yes.
Okay.
No, but not every plastic.
Yeah, because it's itachomeka.
Yes.
Mostly, there's a special one.
I love this one.
A wooden stick.
Yes.
Yeah, kama hii. This one you have, so.
Some wet fry and dry spice. Now I'm prepping for our lioness mm-hmm. to salt them. Some coriander
mm-hmm.
and dry and wet fry spice.
So you one thing about you, Chef Yang, is
yes.
that you know you've gotten to a point in this craft that you're actually transitioning from just cooking in the kitchen to, you know, sort of like inculcating the skills to other young people. Probably just to tell us a bit about what has inspired you to do that and how is it coming along, you know? Meeting Kina Onesmus and other Onesmuses out there, interacting with them, and how is it coming along for you?
Before I brought him up to my camp, this one day somebody told me I will never be on TV.
Eish, uyo ni nani? Na hapa ni wapi?
There's somebody who told me
uyo ni nani?
I will never get to TV. And actually, on my status, I uploaded a picture of me, 2019, when I was trying to get to TV.
Uh-huh.
I was told I will never be on TV.
Uh-huh.
Didn't I know, down the line, I got a chance to meet somebody
uh-huh.
who told me, who believed me from the first day.
Mm.
He saw me and told him, this is what I do. I was given a chance on the first day.
Mm-hmm.
But somebody else had a chance to give me a chance, I can be a no. I saw the way we have gatekeepers in the industry who don't want others to pass through.
Mm.
I saw the hustle. I decided, and for me, when I get this chance, I will make sure I'll be a helper to others people to come to where I am.
Mm.
And that's why I decided to bring him today and introduce him in officially.
Oh, so it's because of the experiences you personally went through when you're trying to break even that you decided other people coming behind you should not go through the same experience.
Yes.
Yeah. So how is it coming along, and
what
is it teaching you?
Yeah, it's teaching me nobody's permanent.
Mm-hmm.
Even the people who refuse to give me that chance, today they look up to me.
Mm-hmm.
They take advice to me from me.
Mm-hmm.
Right now there's a TV show coming up,
uh-huh.
but there's some words in that TV station comes for me. The same people who said I will not be there.
All right.
But they now listen to what I say to them.
All right.
Because my advice is what has made some shows to be where they are.
All right.
Yes.
So after you've coated your chicken with the chips.
Now, we are moving first. We're going to put this here. Then we move to chicken.
Okay.
Nobody chukwe. Take our sieve. Remember, I'm not going to use kidokato.
Okay.
We are avoiding iron.
So is there like a time frame that they are supposed to stay on the oil? Kuna watu wanapenda crunchy, kuna watu wanapenda ikiwa
It depends na wenye order client amepatiana.
So yeah, okay.
Yes.
So ina depend na vile unapenda.
Yes.
Right.
So I have to remove my gloves. Nimeshashika potatoes. So tunaingia the next stage.
All right.
Yeah.
Cleanliness kwa jikoni ni muhimu.
Lazima.
Okay.
Alafu kwa kitchen pia. Tuingiangi na nywele pia.
Unaona mimi nimekaa mbali na
chakula. Nimekaa mbali na chakula.
Sababu mimi ni client leo sasa.
Kiona hata mimi niko na kofia yangu ya chef hapa. Hii inaendaga nayo kila mahali.
Hii ni multi. Kofia by the way ina multitask.
Hii inaenda kila mahali.
Actually he got a new name. Last time when I was coming here, actually was so the end of Mukurino wa kwanza kwa TV.
For real.
Mpishi wa kwanza Mkorino kwa TV.
So, he's stubborn.
Ume break record. Kama Eliud Kipchoge.
Ume break record.
Utakileka iyo pani popo chini.
Saa.
Chunga.
Wakorino wako wapi. Too many messages. Appreciate one of your own. Sindio?
Si kwa church tu. Hatha tunezafanya mambo.
Amazing. So you see the potatoes were now placed in there.
Yes. Some salt.
The onion, the coriander, and the ginger that we had prepared earlier. Yeah.
Now, pick this chicken. Weka hapa kwa mafuta. But pole.
Sawa.
Yeah, wacha sasa tuone.
Pandele ingine pole.
Pole true.
Away from you.
Yeah.
That one is towards you.
That's towards you.
Yes.
Okay. Sawa tu.
But he was a bit careful there.
Yes.
The reason, by the way,
that
is done away from you is to prevent mafuta isiku splash.
Yes.
In case of any accident, you're safe because the hot oil will splash in the opposite direction.
Yes.
Try and be careful in your kitchen.
Remember, hii ni chicken breast.
And then, for those people would like to go extra today, I'm just playing safe. Let's see chesi kama mimi. At this stage, you can turn this lioness potato to tangy potatoes by adding ketchup.
Mm-hmm.
If you add ketchup and some wine, it becomes tangy potatoes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. I guess it's a lot to end your direction.
Yeah.
Lot to maintain too.
hapo kwa wine naweza pata mafansi being a weekend
anaelewa wako na mtu wa kanisa kwa nyumba.
Oh, ah, by the way, so leo tuchezi na wine,
tuko na pasta.
Kuna pasta in the building,
tuko na pasta leo.
There you go.
Let's start continue. Yes, the other one, take this one. Tunaenda. Tukieka hii sehemu.
Wow. Isn't that amazing? Well, if you prepare your potatoes the kawaida way, I mean. Yeah. Can you have it with any other thing? Like, if you're not...
Apart from chicken... Well, what do you prefer? Huh?
No, potatoes. Like, can you do any other?
Yes.
Chicken, wachana nayo. Usiguze kuku. Kuku, wachana nayo. Like, can you unaweza tumia something else?
Yes.
Just options for people to try.
Yeah? By the way, you can try, apart from the potatoes, you can go for arrowroot.
Arrowroot.
There's a signature recipe ambayo, nimeifanya mara mingi. One of the shows nitairudisha hapa. I've never done it here. It's one of the recipe nikikupatia together with cheese inaingiana vizuri sana.
Ah, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
This one of the recipe nimetengeneza. That's one, it can goes very well with this one. Or you can do like, you know, paella. It's a more okay. Sasa nimeanza kwenda.
Explain. Unajua wewe umetembea huko kwa hii world ya chakula, yeah?
Okay, paella. Paella is one of the recipes from Spain. It's a rice dish, actually. It will really nice, go nice with this chicken.
Eh, paella. Ushesikia paella. All right. So we are on our second piece there.
Yes, yes.
The chicken breast stew, but now it's tunatengeneza ile ya pili.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. First of all, after you marinate it for 24 hours.
Yes.
Now this is what you do. Kuna the flour.
Yes.
That you've added cornstarch.
Yes.
And a bit of salt.
Yes.
Then you coat it up kidogo.
Yes, yes.
Eh, why am I taking over your job?
Hapana, endelea tu, endelea tu. Mimi ninafurahia venye unaiexplain.
Then unaiweka kwa mayai.
Naona hivyo sasa.
Yeah. Hiyo mayai ina act kama ile glue, yeah, ya kushikilia everything together, yeah.
Sasa mimi napenda venye unadonjo tu na.
Ndio. As we see what you are doing.
Yes, yes.
And then unaiweka sasa kwa chips pack.
Yeah.
Itaipatia some crunchiness.
Perfect. Yeah, hiyo ndio tunataka.
Ndio.
Kama hii. Abu inayojo.
Yeah, just to see how crunchy.
Yeah, Timo.
It looks.
Ndiyo,
yeah,
sasa.
That is what the chips would do to that chicken, yeah?
Maneno inakaa hivi.
Sasa breast inakaa iko ya miami.
Nakwambia.
Na bado haijamalizika.
Bado
sana.
Weka hapa.
Bado, oh, sa. This is just
bado.
Halfway the process.
Ndio tunaanza.
Nakwambia. Si niliambia mkiona yangu karibu mjue mambo ni extra. Yeah. Yo kusema simple ni wewe. So that is away from me.
Ndio tunaanza. Since nimeguza, that's raw chicken, this is cooked chicken. Change the glove.
Ah, okay.
Don't changanya.
All right.
Na maliza na hiyo. Sasa tunaanza ile manetu.
Unasikia vile ni crunchy.
Na. Nene kitu kama hiyo.
Amazing.
And you can see the juice. Still have the juice.
Okay.
Danny.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Now, we cut them into biteable sizes.
Yeah, please do, because the biters are just next to you. Cut it into biteable sizes. Either I join me some biting at the UCO International Universities, eh?
Mambo inaweza badilika.
Hapo kwa biting. Ndio niko sasa.
Okay. Sakai. Now you move this into a bowl.
So it's not done.
Bado.
Guys.
Bado sana.
Eh.
Bado, ndio tunaanza. There's another pan hapa.
Okay.
Yeah. Sasa hale mambo tunafanya maneno.
Hii ni ile mafuta yetu ama ni ile?
Leo sijaenda extra.
Leo tumeamua. By the way, he has like a signature oil that, I mean, I don't know how many ingredients, but ningapi? I won't ask you to tell us what they are, but...
So far, there's another one pia.
Tuambia kwanza ile ulisema. How many ingredients?
Only kidogo tu inakuwa 7.
7.
Kidogo. If I want to go mild. Uh-huh. Yes, nikienda juu tunafikisha up to 20.
Mix his own oil, uses 7 ingredients. So, yeah. Kuna ingine imetokea tena.
Yeah, there's something nimekuwa nikiwork out nayo. Mm-hmm. Have a new formula. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Ah, okay.
Aya, as he continues there, aya, hapa tutakuwa tunaanza kutengeneza. Sasa, the stir fry for the chicken. Mm-hmm. Aya, if it's the sizzle, mm-hmm. Then we add our onions.
How do you, you know, like measure your ingredients? Like jo ini shule na pia ni, yeah.
The issue
overdo vitu.
The issue of doing it 6 years, it is already stuck in my mind. It just flows.
You can guess.
Yani na flow hiyo
tu. Unaona tu hii ama unaweza hata ona chumvi imetosha kwa macho tu na imetosha.
When you, for me I've done this 6 years repeatedly. It just is me.
Ah, okay.
It's me.
Yeah.
Most of the things I just look and I know the size. Sawa. Yeah. Okay. Some salts. On the colored peppers. Then we get to our dry and wet fry spice. Coriander. Mm-hmm. Today I'm very mild.
What's the difference between the coriander, the one that
is fresh and the one is dried? Mm. This has more flavor than this one.
Okay.
So when you dry this one, there's some flavor, will be mild. Mm. But eco on top kabisa.
Mm. Okay. Yes. Okay. All right.
Turn. Yeah, turn here.
There you go. So Nesmas, tell me a bit about, you know, what is it that you see from people who've gone ahead like Young that you think personally you'd like to add into your own craft to make you someday stand here with somebody else that you're holding?
Yeah, you know,
in this journey.
You know, the first thing, lazima follow the steps. Mm-hmm. How is jump? One step at a time. You know, chef yangu akianza upishi, mimi nilikuwa pale, nilikuwa class. Mm-hmm. So, sunora bado niko nyuma yake. Mm-hmm. So, I must follow the steps so that one day, at animente, nifike to a stage, pia mimi, I can be able to
hold somebody.
To hold someone.
Amazing.
Hata mimi naye nisonge na mtu.
Ah, great.
Yeah.
Great.
Ajua,
is this strict?
Sio rahisi.
Sasa nimekuput on the spot.
Sio rahisi. You know, kuna jua chef yang ile kitu mimi naonanga mzuri kwake. Yeye anakuangalia na kuhelp. Anakwambia help the other person. Unaona? Yaani ni kitu kuna kitu anakuweka ndani, si ile tu upishi peke yake. Pia ako na ile advert. Unajua kuna chef fulani aliniambia I contaminate everything here. Kwa sababu ati I'm young, akaniuliza uko na miaka ngapi, nikamwambia kaniambia, you know, before you were born, I was in a position.
Mm-hmm. Alikuwa anapika.
I was born. Mm-hmm. Yeye alikuwa in a position.
Ona kuku, chef, mbona unatesa watu na niasi?
Sikia sasa hii.
Why between people's breakfast you're just passing with crunchy chicken?
Listen to this. Listen to this perfectly.
Yeah, so crunchy. That is what.
Unasikia? Hii baga inanoa kisu. Sikia yo crunchiness.
Nimechoka, nisha choka tayari.
Taste the feeling.
Ati kuku inanoa kisu.
Yeah. Afu, you can see how juicy. Then you can see how juicy the chicken is.
Yeah. plus the marination, you can already begin to guess.
Yes.
Yeah, vile ina taste. Amazing. Amazing.
Naona timu anaumia.
Amesema utaenda extra lakini. Ah, okay. Chef alisema hataenda extra but
ngidi kidogo tu.
Amejaribu tu kidogo ajaova do.
bado hajafanya more.
Eh, angepewa chance. Kuna siku ametufanyia ma chemistry hapa tukashangaa. Moshi was all over the place. You actually manufactured smoke.
Ah, yeah, but there's
remember that day.
Yeah.
There was smoke that was in a liquid form, man. I was like, this is smoke. Okay.
Today I'm not doing any smoking. I'm just simple. So I'm planning something.
Moshi inaweza kuwa liquid.
I'm planning something big next time.
Eh.
There's something I'm planning to do.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, along my trips then nimekuwa.
Mm-hmm.
I want to bring something.
You learn a lot when you also
travel
and explore.
Yes, things. Yes. Now some ketchup going in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Reduce heat.
And then honey.
Some honey. Mambo inakuwa vula.
Hey.
Unasema utamu. Cheza kama wewe.
Twende nayo.
So ingine ni
so we went, just remind us, we went in there with some bell peppers. Like,
yes, and onions, uh-huh. Which were raw. Mm-hmm. Then cook them a little bit in a simple oil.
Mm.
Simple oil.
Mm-hmm.
Then added some salt, some dry and wet fresh spice, coriander spice. Then after sauteing them for a minute, then you add the chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Then cook them for a few minutes. Then add now the sauce, the chip, the honey, and the ketchup.
Mm.
Yes.
Sasa mambo inakaa hivyo.
Mambo ndio hiyo sasa.
Acha nikuoneshe. It's not my fault.
Kutesa. Acha nikuoneshe.
Tesa
nayo. It's not my fault.
Sasa? You see how your chicken is supposed to be looking?
Okay.
Mambo inakaa vula.
If you are making this with us, pick a picture. Usiogope, just be proud of yourself. Pick a picture yo. Whatever you have made in your kitchen.
Utuweke
hapo kwa Twitter at Citizen TV Kenya. Just be proud. You have done well.
Mm-hmm.
Let us see what you have also
been doing.
Kama wanaweza tu challenge.
Tuone tu, yeah. Kila mtu anza mahali. Plus, I know there are some good cooks huko inje. Ni vile tu maybe wajajita chef, but they are doing some amazing stuff. And we'd like to see what you're making in your... Plus, you can suggest what you want us to make in the next episode. Yeah.
Yeah. Then some toppings. There's a coriander.
Yeah, kiasi tu hapo.
Sasa, Timo...
You know one thing I love about that is the color. The color. I mean, who wouldn't want to dig in?
Sasa mambo inakaa hivyo.
Eh? The color.
Unakula kwa macho. Mambo inakaa hivyo.
Ndio sasa.
Timo tu anacheza kama yeye. Timo anacheza kama yeye.
Yeah.
That's a complete meal hivyo.
Yeah.
Mambo iko vula hii now.
Amazing.
Sasa tunacheza ile pande nyingine. No? Tunakuja hii pande. Hiyo sani. Kuna kitu nafaa tufanye. Mtoa hivyo.
Amazing.
Yeah. Sasa.
Eish. Mambo imeharibika sasa.
Simple stuff, fried chicken. Sidina ya? Inona? Aichezi kama hiyo. Yuko kumbiko? Oh, nsidi. Yeah. Nataka, tucheze. Kisisi.
Ish.
Generous portion.
Look at that.
Be generous with the portion. Usinyanyase mgeni.
Be generous with the chicken. Okay.
Alafu. Sit in here, tweezer. You copale?
This one?
Yeah. Nechukua.
Right. Do you like feel the way I'm feeling when after you've cooked kuna hiyo aji ya kukula hiyo kenye umepika? Do you get that?
You know? I'm already used to.
So for real? Like ukipika kitu tamu kama hiyo feel like you want to eat it.
For me it's picture.
So what gives you the satisfaction as a chef?
When I post that picture I get 10 clients.
To me ni picture.
Picture.
Wewe bora umepiga picha ni hivyo umeshiba.
Mimi yangu iko sawa sababu that one picture.
Is it because unashiba na harufu ama
because for me that one picture will guarantee me 10 clients.
Eish.
And those 10 clients is another.
You have to forgive me. I can't wait now.
I
can't wait now.
Shamaliza. Ukiendelea hivyo. Then I have a sausage. Two sausage hapo. Sidi na avocado.
Poleni. Oh. That chicken, man. Uche kosa words. Yani kila kitu imejel vizuri, like so nicely. Yeah? The salt. You know, there's a way mtu uchanganyikiwa kubalance food ukipika na an ingredient that is sweet na chumvi. Do you know how balancing salt and sugar? Usually you can get it wrong.
Lakini well, sisi wenye tumezoea kitchen.
There's a way hizo vitu zimebalance kabisa.
Yeah, imebalance kabisa. Lazima usiweke chumvi mingi alafu tena uweke something sweet.
Yeah.
Itakuwa inaleta hasara sana.
Oh. Mm. That's something. Eh?
And now, you come to your plate. Take another one.
Ish. Hiyo tu kiletewa hata kama ulikuwa umeshiba. We
unaasimu ulikuwa umekula snack.
Sasa.
Ushaona wale watu mnaenda kwa watu alafu hata tulikuwa tumekula. Please don't do that. Don't do that because you don't know what's cooking.
Sasa mambo iko hivyo.
Hata tumekula nyumbani.
Yes.
Hata tushakula alafu unaletewa something like this, my friend. There you go. Amazing. He says, "Yeah, picha tu shashiba."
Yes, because
Poleni tumwatesa, but this is what we made this morning. What inspired? I usually like to ask. Yeah.
Yes.
Kati yenu nani alichagua hii recipe? Kwanza ndio nimuulize.
I'm the one who came with it.
Wewe ndio ulichagua.
Yes.
So what inspired you? Because kila time tukiwa na chef, akiulizwa unataka kupika nini, anasema ndapika hii. There's a reason why anataka kupika hiyo. So what made you choose this for today? What is it that
One thing, chicken is my favorite meal. And I thought I have not done a bit of chicken in the show. I said let me do something special for my host.
Aish, mlijua napenda kuku.
Ulijua. Sasa tena. Tena nakumbuka ile sehemu.
Ile napenda sana.
Ile sehemu.
It's good you have that memory.
Yes.
All right. So at this point, you know, the last time we had a conversation, there was a lot that you were planning to do in terms of just showcasing the talent in this industry. Sijui kama kulikuwa umeorganize ama ndio una plan to organize some sort of like cooking competition.
Yes.
Yeah. Is it cooking marathon? I just need you to tell me a bit about
actually
how that is coming along.
What is coming along right now? I'm working on my second street competition. I have done the first one. This is the second one. That's why I want first to empower the chefs. I want them to have a face outside. And when I'm organizing that competition, they have a people will recognize them. They have spotted them somewhere. I want first to give them the face, then I put them in the street because that's where the money is. For me, I don't check you where there's no money. I want to put you where there are people who are going to give you those jobs. I make sure when I'm making that event, because right now I'm pulling more sponsorship on my side, and I have a company that I'm a brand ambassador to, which now I'm pulling the strings for money at the moment. I want first to empower everybody's in my camp, then I put them in the street. After that, I make sure every chef is working and is earning. I have no issue.
All right. Onesmus, from your end, as somebody who is up and rising in this craft, what are some of the things that you find challenging, you know, for somebody to really break even. Ni challenges gani zile unaona ziko kwa industry for young chefs who are trying to break even?
Okay, challenges zenye ziko kwa industry na we as young chefs ni first of all lack of respect. Young chefs hawataki ku respect. Ukijiona umejua kukanga kitunguu pale na nini, unajiona uko sawa.
Oni wao wanakosa.
Hao ndio wanakosa
respect. Si ati wanakosa.
Opportunities ziko. Opportunities ziko. Mentors wako. Ile kitu wanakosa ni respect. Yeah, hawataki kuenda ile extra mile ya kutaka kujua wakati umebuy bundles pale nyumbani. Wao wanataka tu ku make content. Tumie hiyo page yako ya online kutafuta job, kutafuta opportunities, tafuta platform. Wacha kutafuta tu ni nini na trend. We as chefs, I want to encourage you na niwa please sana. We as young chef, wacha tu tujaribu sana each and every day to make sure we make a step. Learn something new each and every day. Each and every day. Each and every day. Kwa page yako, alafu tena kuna kitu nasumbua tena hapo. Mashef sana. Alcohol.
Napenda chupa sana.
Sana.
Speak, mtumishi ongea. Speak to the young people.
Alcohol inamaliza chefs kabisa. Inamaliza, na kuna kitu nyenye sitasema.
Wewe umekubali?
Arafu, the other thing, the issue is, kwanza when you are a male as a chef, of course, you have a lot of redis on our inbox. Ni kawaida, tumezoea kukatiwa.
Okay.
You're in the kawaida. We have a lot of ladies.
Who doesn't want somebody who knows how to cook good things like this? Eh?
So when you're a chef, you fall into temptation of having a lot of ladies. You lose focus.
Because wameja na wanawake. Tafadhali.
Zimeja kwa DM. Hata wamama utaona kwa DM.
Unataka kusema hiyo?
Nimeona ameogopa. So if you fall into trap ya ladies who wanakukatia. Actually, they go direct to the point, what they want, our pity candle. So if you fall into that trap where you say yes to one, she passes the message to the best friend.
But you see, it's blame it on the food. I mean, you cook so well.
If you want to fade very fast as a chef. No, if you want to fade very fast as a chef, put women. Yes, women and alcohol. They don't work in our industry.
Yeah. Yes. Probably, young, what are some of the things, mistakes you made, you know, when you were starting out? Zile ulijifunza from, like, what are some of the things you would say?
Mistakes?
Vitu kujua.
Not fast, but company in the kitchen. Kuna hala unakuchochanga. Unaenda kufanya hiyo kazi kama nani? Wewe achia wengine wafanye. Wewe unaacha. Kumbe hiyo kitu anakuambia usiende kufanya ndio itakutoka hiyo step kupatia promotion. Unakataa kufanya. That's one. Second thing, peer pressure. Uko tuko naye kwa kitchen, there's a menu on the board, you don't want to follow the menu. You assume you are better than the person who put that menu there.
Yeah.
So kakiburi.
Hiyo alikuwa anasema kuna kakiburi fulani .
And then the issue comes here when you are young and you are smart or genius. Nobody can tell you anything. Nobody.
A young person who is a genius is dangerous.
Nobody. Because even for me when I was starting, actually there's a picture I've uploaded when 2019. Madam Shaz usually tell me, Chef Young, I can see you doing something, but I don't know what you want to do with your art, but try to figure it out. I was never knowing where I was going at that moment when I met the ambassador. The ambassador is the one who gave me the direction. I've worked with different people, but when I met the Paris ambassador, she just told me directly, avoid being a restaurant chef. Stop looking job only in restaurants. We have hospitals. We have cruise ships. We have private chefs, like what I do. For me, it's private chef. I'm not in a line cook. For me, my time is money. When you call me, you know that moment you're calling me from, that moment it's money. I'm not there to stand there for a whole day.
Not make money. You know, that's the thing. I mean, there are people who, probably young people who are watching and they would like to do this. And it's they're more driven by the reward that comes with it. What would you advise that young person? First, anataka tu pesa. Me, nataka make it, nataka do. So is there money in this industry?
One, there's money, but...
There's a but again.
If you put money first, you lose important clients. And the important clients give you that money because of the big checks that comes in. You have to do, you have to balance off. You must learn something called client reliability and having that good client services with them. There's sometimes you have a client ambaye anakusumbua but anatoa pesa mzuri. So unazima uvumilie. So
uvumilia shida.
What uvumilia?
Those are the so-called difficult clients.
Yeah. So what uvumilie? Because you know, at the end of the day, those are the people who pays the good money. Second thing, don't come in looking for money, you don't have skills. You want money, yes, but you have skills. For me, I'm a sushi chef. I'm an Indian chef. But for me, when you call me for sushi, you have to prepare for good money. Because per hour is 4,000.
Eh, okay.
So you calculate the hours I'm going to be there.
So value for money. There's one thing that also is quite a challenge about people going to study things to get a job in what they've studied.
Yes.
In this world of being a chef, you know, as somebody who mentors young chefs, is that mindset the right mindset? Ntakuja nisome nipate kazi.
Saizi Kenya sio Kenya uko nayo ni unani unajua. Let's be honest.
Usivunje roho ya watu.
Ni ukweli. Ni ukweli. Ni unani unajua. Because where I am, if I want something, it is who I know. It's where I will put you. If you don't know anybody, chances are very slim. But no, people have godfathers now in the company. But always put God first. You never know when that chance is going to be yours. Provided you have the best skills that that company needs, God will just put you where you are needed to be. For me, I usually say, time changes everything. Because my story comes from the time. When I was in 2019 and now, huge difference.
Huge difference.
Huge difference.
Kuna kitu nimeona hapa.
Yes, yes.
Pardon us, we have some juiciness going on there.
Yes.
But this is like the best Kenyan food stylist, eh?
Yes.
I want to know the story behind
actually
this title.
That came from Germany. Straight from Germany to Kenya, direct to my one of my kitchen, pale Naivasha. It's one of the things I've been doing for years. People, let me tell you, that thing that you do and you think people don't see it, people see it. Rewards comes in many forms. Not every client will give you a tip, but you may never know that day you are serving a food inspector. But you may never know that day you are serving a food inspector. So never look, always focus on the tips. Focus on bringing that client tomorrow. When I did my best for that guest, I never knew he's somebody who deals with food. So they go and discuss in Germany, organize something for me. This is actually one of the items I got from Germany. It was shipped to Germany personally. And brought to me. And actually, there's more awards coming outside from Germany to Kenya. Actually, what I'm telling you, never fail to do something good because you just want to be given money ndio ufanye kitu. It's not always about money. One good thing that you do today can be something that you can be eating it up for the rest of your life. For me, I've made connections with top people in the government through food. I've learned my lesson, never underestimate anybody, no matter how they look like. Never underestimate
Treat
anybody.
Treat everybody equally.
Yes.
Onesmus, after having heard all that and, you know, interacted with young, I mean, what would be your, as we are about to bring this to a close, what would be your biggest inspiration that you drew from his journey and the journey of other chefs probably that you look up to? Maybe three or four things that stand out for you. Yeah.
Okay, the first thing is lazima uvumilie. Yeah, lazima uvumilie. The second thing, set your standard.
Jua unaenda wapi?
Know your direction. Usi, the third thing, don't chase positions as in yani unasoma pale unataka I want to be head chef. sous chef. Those are just names. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. Na ikikuja itajileta.
Kama ni yako ni
yako. Inakujanga tu yenyewe.
Kama ni yako ni yako. The third thing, ujielewe. Mm. Yeah. Know your value. Mm. Know your standard. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Hivyo tu.
All right, I'm set your standard akasema hapo kwa standard amesisitiza sana. Especially when it comes to food, I mean kuna tu vile wewe unafaa ufanye mambo yako and you can't go lower than that. All right.
Ukisha set standard yako, hiyo ndio ina ku drive. Hiyo tu.
All right.
Na ukue na respect.
All right.
Ukue na respect. Hivyo tu.
All right.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, both of you, for creating time. Now, this is the moment you give us your final words. Kama kuna mtu mnakitaka kusalimia, I mean, in the opportunity. Umefanya, ni kama nili. Silete kitabu.
Hapana.
Mimi kiendelea.
My lovely mom, she's watching. And to my lovely, beautiful wife, Zainab. I can see her in studio. And to my perfect team that is here, nashukuru sana for always supporting me and always being with me. And to mostly one important person listening, she's been there for me. Namshukuru sana.
Mm.
Yes, yes.
Okay, for me.
Thank you so much.
Mom, big up sana. Big up sana. Dad, big up sana. Yes, wezi kosa, yes, wezi forget. At wezi leta mshipi hapa. Chef Yang. Thank you, brother.
Asante.
Eish. Where?
Asante.
Na kwa wife? Apo kwa wife? Anywhere.
Anyway, oh yeah.
Thank you so much.
Our numbers. We give them our numbers.
Social media, Twitter.
Yeah. Everywhere, Chef Yang's Kitchen. My number is 0714989285.
Thank you so much.
Okay. My number, 0707560053. Everywhere. Nesh.
Okay, thank you so much for watching Citizen TV this particular Thursday. We really appreciate your time and company. Next week, we do this again. So it's another episode that you do not want to miss for now. It's a wrap. Enjoy the rest of your day, the rest of your weekend, and keep watching Citizen TV.